Hello everyone, in today's lecture 28, we will understand what is absence quotas, what are the methods to generate absence quotas, what do you mean by quota deduction, and how to create the info type 2006, which is basically the absence quotas info type. Let's understand what is meant by absence quotas. In absence quotas, which is info type 2006, you can manage the time accounts, for example, employee's annual vacation or sick leave. So if you are an employee of a company, you will be entitled to a vacation for 1 year, like 20 days or 80 hours. So that is nothing but your quota. So when you apply vacation for 1 hour or 1 day, then that quota will be deducted and you can able to see, like you will be able to see how much is the remaining balance before you apply again for the vacation. Now, what are the different methods to generate the absence quotas? You can use different methods to generate the absence quotas for employees according to company's requirement. SAP has provided three different options. The first one is automatic generation in time evaluation. There is a program called as RPTime00, which is nothing but time evaluation. This can be used to generate the quota automatically for the group of employees. Now the second one is calculation of absence quotas using a report called as RPTQTA00. So this report, which is called as RPTQTA00, can also be used to generate the absence quotas. The third option is you can manually go and create directly the absence quotas in info type 2006. Before you create, there will be some config settings you have to make, and there will be some minor configuration you have to play around to basically allow the system to create the info type 2006 manually. Now, what is quota deduction? Quota deduction, as I mentioned you earlier, like you will be entitled to a quota like 40 hours of vacation per year. Now, if you apply vacation for 1 day or 2 days or 4 hours, because some companies give the entitlement based on number of hours, and some companies they give the entitlement based on number of days. So either you apply in hours or you apply in terms of days, that quota will be deducted. That is nothing but quota deduction. And in SAP your configuration, you need to tell the system that the quota should be deducted. Now let's create info type 2006 after you decide which method you want to basically use to generate the absence quota, and also see how the quota can be deducted. So let's go to our SAP logon. So I am logging to SAP, logging my user ID. Let me put up my password. Now I am into SAP. I am going SPRO for my configuration, clicking on IMG. I am navigating to the time management. This is the time management. So I am expanding the time management node here. So this is time data recording and administration. So if you open this, in our previous lecture we have basically, you know, configured the different absences, right? Now when you have to configure the quotas, then you have to come to this point in the navigation. What is this? Managing time accounts using attendance and absence quotas. So now I expand this. Now this screen will come, this navigation. I again go and expand this and expand this, so that you know what is the configuration needed to create the absence quota. So in the previous lecture I told you how to group the employee subgroups for time quotas and how to group your personal sub areas for time quotas. I have been always reminding you that this grouping is separate for each aspect in time management. For example, personal sub-area grouping for work schedule, it could be different because it depends upon which personal sub-areas have the same working time. That grouping is different. But here, this grouping is for time quotas, meaning if particular sub-areas have the same quotas, like one personal sub-area has vacation quota and sick quota, and another sub-area also have the same quota like vacation quota and sick quota, then you can group those personal sub-areas to a one grouping. Similarly, employee subgroups for time quotas means like you are allowing salaried employee to have vacation and hourly employee to also have vacation, then you can basically group them to a single group. Even though they are belonging to different employee subgroups, but since they have the same absence quotas, you can basically group to a single group. Now let us go to this employee subgroups for time quotas. So here in this one, it is asking which country. I'm telling USA, which is number 10. I hit enter. Now I'm searching for my employee group. So if you see, these were the employee group subgroups which we configured. Now I'm giving grouping number 1. So that it is just for my identification and also for the system that these two employee subgroups are having the same quotas. So now I gave the grouping 1. I'm coming back. And now you have the group personal sub areas for time quotas. Click on this. Now here you have to basically group your personal sub areas who have the same absence quotas. So now I have grouped my personal sub areas like Zenith Chicago, Zenith Houston to this group number 09. So basically it means like these two personal sub areas have the same absence quotas. Now after I define the grouping, now I have to go and create the absence quotas. I basically define the absence quota, like whether you are trying to define vacation or sick. This is not an absence type. Don't get confused with absence type and the quota. Absence type is different. Absence type could be vacation, leave or sick leave, different. Quota is the bucket which has the number, total number which you are eligible for 1 year or a particular period of time. So now I'm going to define absence quotas, quota types. I'm clicking on this here. This screen comes up. So what I have done here for my employee subgroup grouping and my personal sub area grouping for the time quotas, I have defined a quota called as Zenith vacation quota. If you see here, employee subgroup for time quota types, that grouping we have given the number 1, and the personal sub area grouping for time quotas, which is number 09, and I have given a number such as 15, any number is fine. And I have defined the basically, I've given the description for this quota type, which is nothing but Zenith vacation quota. And I'm telling the system that this quota should be number of hours. It could be number of days also, as mentioned. It totally depends on the company's requirement if they want to give this entitlement, I mean the quota, in terms of hours or in terms of days. Now, what is time constant class? This is very important topic here. Time constant class means it basically the system reacts if a person who is applying two different sort of absence types on the same day. Think of it, you must have applied tomorrow vacation and then you just forgot. And then today what you are doing, again you are applying for sick leave for tomorrow. And the system knows, hey, this guy already applied for vacation on this day. Now he is again up trying to apply sick leave on that this particular date. So the system gives an error message because there is a collision here. There are colliding of the records, two records. So there is the collision between two particular records of the same info type. I mean info type 2001 is absence info type, right? So now you are creating two different absences on the same day. How will the system record? You cannot be vacation as well as you cannot be on sick leave on the same day, right? So system will help you there to remind you, hey, you cannot apply because there is already one record created. So I am putting 01, meaning that only one record can be created at a time. I am saving. back. Now I have defined my absence quota. Now in my slide I told you that there are different methods actually to create the absence quotas, either through the reports or you can directly go and manually create the input type 2006. So let us tell the system, like whatever the absence quota type I have created, I want the system to know that this is a quota type which I want to create in info type 2006 directly. So if you see here, calculating absence in entitlement, how you want to calculate the absence quota. Entitlement is nothing but quota, right? So here if you see automatic or accrual absence quotas, if you expand this and then click on this particular IAM, what is it? Permit quota generation without time violation. What is time violation? In the slide I told you there is a program name called as RPTimeTE00. So if you go with that method, you should basically tell the system that it should go with that method. If you do not want to go with that method, then also you need to tell the system that, hey, I don't want to generate the quota based on that particular report. I want to create the quota directly in info type 2006. Now let us click on this here. Now search for your quota, the quota for my grouping 1 and 09. If you see, this was the quota which I created. So if you recall, if you go back, you will see that I created an absence quota type 15, which is Zenith vacation quota. Here I have basically selected the radio button no generation, meaning I am telling the system, hey, you don't have to generate the absence quota, I will go and create it manually. That is the reason why you have selected these two options here. Now not two options, I mean basically I have also created another absence quota for my grouping, so that's what I meant. I'm selecting for both these absence quotas, I have selected the radio button no generation. No generation means I don't want the system to automatically generate the absence quota, I want to go manually and create the absence quota. Now after this my work is done, meaning I have grouped those employee subgroups, I have grouped the personal sub areas, I have defined the absence quotas. Also I have told the system, hey, now basically I am going to create the absence quotas.